Security Assertion Markup Language, or SAML, is a standard that specifies an XML-based framework for exchanging authentication data over the web. In SAML, business applications act as SAML service providers. They rely on a SAML authority, such as an identity provider, to authenticate their users. This eliminates the need for enterprises to maintain individual authentication systems for each application. It also enables users to access multiple applications after signing in just once. You can transform a Pass for OpenEdge web application into a SAML 2.0 service provider by setting a few simple properties. However, note that a Pass for OpenEdge web application does not directly interact with end users or identity providers. Instead, you must develop a Pass for OpenEdge client application to perform those tasks. This client application could be browser-based, such as a JavaScript or Kendo UI Builder application, or even a command line tool like curl, which is used for automating REST calls. So how does SAML work in Pass for OpenEdge? In a typical scenario, a user connects to a Pass for OpenEdge client application via a user agent, such as a browser or a command line console. The user may then perform some action, such as clicking a link on a web page, that requires the processing of a resource deployed on a Pass for OpenEdge web application. This is when the SAML workflow begins. The client application must generate and send a SAML request to a trusted identity provider. The identity provider presents the user with a security challenge, such as a login page. If the user's credentials are correct, the identity provider generates a SAML response containing a SAML assertion, which it sends to the Pass for OpenEdge client application. The client application must then pass the SAML assertion to the Pass for OpenEdge web application. The Pass for OpenEdge web application validates the assertion and creates a client principal object, which it delivers to an ABL class or method. After the ABL class or method completes executing, Pass for OpenEdge returns the result to the client application. Finally, the Pass for OpenEdge client displays the result to the user. In this video, we'll look at an example of how a SAML workflow can be set up in Pass for OpenEdge. The sample Pass for OpenEdge web application that we'll use consists of a REST URI mapped to an ABL class, which contains a method to return a customer record based on customer ID. For our client application, we will use two types of clients, a browser-based Node.js application and a command line utility called curl. Finally, for our identity provider, we'll use Okta. When you are implementing SAML in Pass for OpenEdge, you'll find that there are two points of communication. First, the Pass for OpenEdge client application must be able to exchange SAML messages with an identity provider. Second, the same client must be able to send SAML assertions to your Pass for OpenEdge web application. The Pass for OpenEdge client establishes trust with an identity provider by exchanging metadata, which describes each entity's attributes, such as entity ID, public key, endpoints, etc. Our Okta application is configured to work with our Pass for OpenEdge client. The single sign-on URL points to the assertion consumer service URL of our Pass for OpenEdge client application. This is the endpoint to which Okta will send SAML response messages. The audience URI is the location where Okta will find our Pass for OpenEdge client's metadata. The assignments tab displays users assigned to this application. Only those users will be allowed to access our Pass for OpenEdge resources. Here is Okta's metadata. It contains, among other things, the public key certificate, the entity ID, and HTTP bindings. It also identifies the location where the Okta application expects to receive SAML requests. Now let's quickly review our Node.js client application. Don't worry if you're not familiar with Node.js. The goal is to get an outline of how you could develop a similar client application in the programming framework of your choice. The service provider object in our Node.js code builds the assertion consumer service URL and the metadata URL, which match our Okta application's properties. The identity provider object contains properties derived from the Okta application's metadata. Notably, the SSO_login_URL property is set to the URL where the Okta application expects SAML requests. There are, of course, many other SAML properties that need to be set on both sides, but this should give you a sufficient overview of how you could integrate a Pass for OpenEdge client with an identity provider. Now let's look at a second point of communication, the one between our Pass for OpenEdge client and our Pass for OpenEdge web application. Our Node.js client application must send the SAML assertion that it receives from Okta to a REST URI in our Pass for OpenEdge web application. The SAML assertion must be passed via the authorization HTTP header with the prefix SAML. For our OpenEdge web application to accept and validate the SAML assertion, we need to set up SAML in the OEAVL security.properties file. At minimum, two properties need to be set. The client login model must be set to SAML, and the metadata files must be downloaded and their path set, both for the Pass for OpenEdge client as well as the identity provider. The metadata files contain public keys and other information used by the Spring security layer in Pass for OpenEdge to validate the SAML assertion. To implement authorization, you need to set up your identity provider to pass roles as optional attributes in the SAML assertion, as we did here in our Okta application. To make this work in Pass for OpenEdge, you must set the optional attributes attribute name in the role attribute name property. To authorize the user, Pass for OpenEdge compares the values of this attribute in the SAML assertion with the role URI definition in your OEABLsecurity.csv file. In our example, the role PSC user is defined for all REST URIs. There are a few other SAML properties that can be optionally configured. To learn more about them, refer to the documentation. Let's test our SAML setup. First, we'll use the Node.js client. Let's use a browser to call the URI that initiates the SAML request. As you can see, the browser is redirected to Okta, which presents us with a login page. Let's enter the credentials of the user assigned to our Okta application. Finally, we see the results from our Pass for OpenEdge web application. Let's take a quick look at the SAML request and response messages in Chrome's DevTools. Our Node.js application issued a redirect with a SAML request to our Okta application. The Okta application sent back a SAML response. We can also test our SAML setup using curl. For this video, we have saved a SAML assertion, which we'll pass in the authorization header using a curl command. As you can see, the Pass for OpenEdge web application responds with the desired result. As it does for all authentication methods, the Spring security layer in Pass for OpenEdge produces a client principal object that it passes to the ABL application. Let's verify this. For this video, we have written an ABL procedure to log the client principal's attribute values, which are derived from the SAML assertion's attributes. As you can see, the client principal object has indeed been created. The user ID, domain name, and session ID have been picked up from the SAML assertion. This concludes our overview of SAML in Pass for OpenEdge.